2 years into the devastating COVID-19 pandemic, just when there were hopes of the worst of the pandemic being over, the virus seems to be showing up no signs of a letup. On the contrary, it continues to keep mutating and coming back with stronger variants threatening to engulf humankind all over again. The World Health Organization has named the new B.1.1.529 variant as Omicron. It was named after a letter in the Greek alphabet to avoid stigmatizing the country it was detected in. It has been dubbed as the super strain as it is believed to be spreading faster than the Delta variant. Here's everything you need to know about this new strain, which has sparked fears of another devastating wave across the globe. The virus strain, which was first detected in South Africa, has been classified as a highly transmissible virus of concern. Although health experts are yet to fully understand the Omicron variant, it is identified to have 30 mutations in its spike protein. Spike protein is what the virus uses to get into human cells. This is about double the number of spike protein present in the Delta variant, thereby making it substantially different from the original coronavirus. The Omicron variant is also genetically distinct from previous variants. A cluster of mutations known as H655Y plus N679K plus P61H associated with more efficient cell entry have been identified in the Omicron. There is also a deletion of the NSP6. It also carries the R203K plus G204R mutations, which are associated with increased infectivity. All of these indicate enhanced transmissibility and evasion of innate immunity. A WHO panel called the Technical Advisory Group met on November 26 to assess the new variant. The group has stated that early evidence suggests Omicron carries an increased risk of reinfection when compared to other highly transmissible variants, including its predecessor, the Delta variant. This means that people who contracted COVID-19 and recovered from it will also be vulnerable to reinfections. Existing vaccines are also likely to be less effective against this variant, although it may take weeks before anything can be established. The WHO has also called upon all countries to increase their surveillance and virus sequencing efforts to better understand this and other circulating variants. The variant has triggered a surge in South Africa as it went from witnessing 200 cases per day to over 2,000 cases per day over the last week. The African continent on the whole has been witnessing a 320% surge in infections with the outbreak of this variant. In its advisory for the general public, the WHO has advised people to wear well-fitting masks, practice hand hygiene and physical distancing, improve ventilation of indoor spaces, avoid crowded spaces, and get vaccinated. Besides South Africa, Omicron has also been detected in Botswana, Israel, Belgium, and Hong Kong. Soon after Omicron was classified as a variant of concern, the US, UK, Canada, and European Union nations announced travel restrictions on those traveling from South Africa and its neighboring countries. Globally, stock markets and oil prices plunged on Friday amidst fears surrounding the new variant, potentially dealing a heavy blow to global economic recovery. In India, Prime Minister Narendra Modi chaired a meeting of top officials on Saturday to discuss the situation and the vaccination drive. India has directed all states to aggressively test and screen international travelers from South Africa and other at-risk countries. A federal report.